Next, we have this name that I'm doing very poorly with. Hima? Hima, welcome to the Senate Oversight Committee. After her will be Melissa Carone and James Danley. Hima, welcome to the Senate Oversight Committee. Can you tell me how to say your last name correctly?
Kolanagi Reddy.
So now everybody else can know.
The moment I saw you holding on to that card, I'm like, that's me. That's got to be me.
Well, you have 3 minutes, so thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak. This is my first time doing this as a poll challenger at TCF. As an immigrant to this country, as you can tell, we had great respect for America, the elections here. We always thought it has a lot of integrity, whereas the countries we come from, a lot of things happen. But all of that changed the day I went there. Like, I was at TCF on both the days, third and the fourth. Third was pretty much the same monotonous stuff going on, nothing much to note, other than occasional ballot challenging. But the next day is where I noticed a lot of issues. There was a group of people who were like agitators who were trying to get GOP people in trouble. And from my skin color, everybody assumes that I'm a Democrat. And so they just kind of come to me. And one of the ladies was singing that, let's get these MFs out. And I'm like, MFs who? Like, because she thought I was a Democrat. Then when I pulled out my tag, she looked at me and she's like, you're on the wrong side. I'm like, how can you say I'm on the wrong side? I pick whoever I want, right? Because this is a free country. But then I noticed that they were going and getting all the white male Republicans out by, you know, just kind of sheer intimidation, you know, just saying, oh, your mask flipped, you're going to get people killed, like you heard from so many other people. And then what I did was I got trained by both the MIGOP and Election Integrity Fund. So I went to Tim Griffin of Election Integrity Fund and I said, can I have my nonpartisan credentials? And then when I got that badge on, everything changed. Like, people just looked at me differently. I was looked at with a lot of hostility when I had the GOP tag. And now that I have a nonpartisan tag, I was respected at the counting boards. I was respected by the Democrats and the ACLU. And in fact, I was able to even help some of the GOP people from being escorted out by putting myself there and asking why they were even being escorted out and arguing with these people. But the whole environment was so hostile and condescending. And a lot of people have talked about the, you know, the ballots that were not in the poll book or the system. And I was at a table which had a full stack of this file which said not in EPB/S, which is poll book or system. They were scanning and manually entering them, and the signatures on those sleeves were exactly alike, like a bar graph. And then they were sequential ballot numbers. They started from 2232, and sequence was something that threw me off. I'm like, how does that happen? And most of those people were from the guarded street, and they were being entered manually. So those were the observations that I had. I had all the details, the last names and everything. I gave the affidavit to the Election Integrity Fund. The thing that bothered me was that when every time a GOP challenger was being escorted out, all the poll workers, Democrats, and everybody else were cheering. And that was very disappointing because these people were just doing their job. They were not attacking. They were not there with guns. They were just volunteering their time, and they were treated with utmost disrespect.
Thank you for your time, your testimony. Could you briefly go back to just a few seconds ago? You mentioned how you saw some ballots that were sequential, and then you described them somehow, and I missed the phrase that you used.
Where
they came from, I think you mentioned.
Yeah, it was from Goddard Street in Wayne County.
Like, oh, you know, Garden Street, okay.
Yeah, and they all had sequential ballot numbers, and they were being manually fed into the system.
Okay, thank you. Any other members have a question? Okay, thank you so much for your
time.
Thank
you.